According to the February 2023 Steam Hardware Survey, just over 1% of Steam users game with an RX580. In 2021, Steam reported having over 132 million active users worldwide, meaning over 1.3 million gamers are currently using an RX580. And for those thinking about using theirs to play some PC VR, let's take a look at what kind of performance you can expect. In Pavlov, one of VR's most popular shooters, I was able to get the RX580 to run at 72 Hz at 3936 by 1984, which is just slightly above the native resolution of the Quest 2, with the in-game setting set to what you're seeing on screen right now. I did try it at 90 Hz with the render resolution slightly lower, and the RX580 actually did great most of the time. There were moments where the 580 wasn't quite able to keep up, and the frame rate would drop in half for a little bit, but overall the frame rate was solid. The thing that made me decide to switch to 72 Hz is the graphics looked much sharper and clearer on the Quest 2 at 72 Hz, as opposed to 90 Hz with the RX580. I've seen a fair amount of people complain online about the video encoder on the RX580, and they're right. AMD's encoder on the 580 is pretty trash compared to Nvidia's. The graphics quality was so much worse at 90 Hz than at 72 Hz. You can't really see it in these captures, but if I lower the resolution of this clip a little bit, I can at least simulate for you what it looked like in the headset. Looks nice, doesn't it? Beat Saber ran great on the RX580 at 90 Hz with the settings you see on screen, but just like with Pavlov, the video quality at 90 Hz looked like poo. This is, of course, only a problem for me because I'm using a Quest 2 to test with. If I was using an Index or a Rift S or something that uses DisplayPort rather than USB, this wouldn't be an issue since you're getting a direct video signal rather than a transcoded one. Because of the poor video quality at 90 Hz, I turned the refresh rate down to 72 Hz, where things look much better. With the increase to performance headroom from lowering the refresh rate, I was even able to bump the render scale in Beat Saber up from 1.3 to 1.5, making the game look very, very nice. I should mention I did all my testing using a link cable because the graphics were abominable with AirLink. That video encoder on the 580 is just terrible. Also, in my test PC, I'm running an AMD Ryzen 7 5800X 3D CPU, 32GB of DDR4 3600MHz CL16 RAM, and our GPU is the 8GB XFX Radeon RX 580 GTS. Vader Immortal is another game the 580 ran pretty well at 90Hz. To be clear, most parts of the game ran perfectly at 90fps, but there were some segments where it was a little more than the 580 could handle, and the frame rate would drop on down. But once again, the graphics looked way better at 72Hz on the Quest 2, so here's the settings I ended up going with for that.
I knew we shouldn't have trusted you.
No! Vader only seeks the bright star. Now that he has it, he will leave us in
enough.
Contractors is the last of the games I tried running at 90 Hz. At 3936 by 1984 with the in-game settings as noted on screen, Contractors ran great. But just like with all the other games I tried at 90 Hz, the visuals look terrible. And knowing the 580's encoder handles 72 Hz much better, I switched to 72 Hz, which I found much more visually pleasing. And thanks to the additional headroom we gained from lowering the refresh rate, I was able to increase some of the other settings a little bit to make things look just that much better. I had to set the in-game graphics settings as low as they go, but the RX 580 ran The Walking Dead Saints and Sinners pretty well at 3648 by 1856 at 72 Hz. It did struggle a bit with areas with dynamic lighting, like right here at the swamp skiff and when looking at the map in the bus. But as I was wandering around from place to place and collecting loot and stuff, the game ran nicely, and most of the time we had plenty of available performance headroom. When fighting with walkers, though, the frame rate in this game always drops in half. If you've seen any of my other reviews, you already know about this. I guess getting up close and personal with a zombie is just as intense an experience for a GPU as it is for you or I, and it pees itself just a little bit. Red Matter 2 is one of the more visually impressive games available for VR right now, and the RX 580 performed well in this game. In my testing, the only times I saw the frame rate drop below my 72 FPS target was when I was in the two areas of the game that I know to be the most difficult areas of the game for a GPU to render. Both of these areas have large glass windows with reflections on them and other lighting effects going on in the scene. The RX580 actually handled these areas really well overall, but once I pulled out the laser scanning tool and the GPU had to render its reflection in the glass too, that's when our frame rate took a dive. Other than that though, everywhere else I went in the game, the RX580 had no problem at all. Assetto Corsa is one of those games that even with all the graphic settings turned down, it still looks pretty good. With all the in-game graphic settings set pretty much as low as they go, and the render resolution at 4192 by 2128, the RX580 delivered a solid 72 FPS and a pretty nice driving experience. Microsoft Flight Simulator is the most hardware-demanding game I know of. So, going into this test, I strongly suspected we would not be hitting our target frame rate. And this turned out to be correct. In this training flight over Sedona, Arizona, the 580 gave us a consistent 36 FPS, which actually doesn't feel too terrible since Flight Simulator is a very slow-paced game. Even when I switched to the Discovery flight over New York City, the frame rate stayed pretty solid. There was some fluctuation, but any major dips were only momentary and the compositor didn't drop any frames, so the flight felt fairly smooth. Unfortunately, at these settings, the visuals are very blurry and pixelated, making the cockpit instruments pretty much unreadable. So while the RX580 can give you a taste of VR flight simulator, it's certainly not a GPU I would readily recommend for it. Lone Echo 2 is another game that is very demanding. The graphics in it are gorgeous, but you do need a very powerful GPU to be able to fully enjoy them. In most areas of the game, the RX580 is able to stay above 72 FPS with everything set to low, and the render resolution in the Oculus app set to 2432 by 1216. Areas like this one though, where there's a lot of this reddish glowing biomass, are more difficult for a GPU to render, so you'll notice the frame rate dropping down here. The compositor wasn't dropping frames though, and similar to Flight Simulator, Lone Echo 2 is a slower paced game, so despite the low frame rate and low resolution visuals, I felt the overall gameplay experience was okay. Since its launch in 2020, Half Life Alyx remains the best game VR currently has on offer. And you'll be happy to know the RX580 delivers a very enjoyable experience in this game. Yes, I did have to play it on the low fidelity preset, but with the resolution at 3936 by 1984, the visuals still look really good, and the game plays wonderfully. The only part in my testing where the 580 struggled was when I was fighting this electric dog thing. It has the ability to inhabit the bodies of dead zombies and then tries to fry you with lightning. Gameplay got a little choppy at this part, but just like with Flight Simulator and Lone Echo 2, the compositor didn't drop any frames, and these segments didn't last for too long, so I was able to make it through them before experiencing any real discomfort. Overall, I feel the RX580 is a decent starting point for someone looking to try out some PC VR. Its poor transcoding performance, however, makes it a tough sell for people running a Quest 2, which statistically speaking is going to be close to half of you watching this. Anyway, if you're looking for a better experience than the 580 can offer, check out my Can It VR playlist right here, where you can take a look at the VR performance of a variety of different GPUs. And it just may help you decide what GPU you might want to upgrade to. Subscribe! In the
dark. You're free now. It's okay. Your friend sent me.
The Alyx Vance. You are a